especially around the attractions. They are behaving themselves, but anytime you have a thunderstorm, you have lightning, of course, we want folks to be caught up on what's going on. So let's take you back outside. There's Claremont. We had a nice heavy downpour there early. In fact, portions of Sumter and Lake County, nearly 3 inches of rain today. And as we head over towards the attractions now, I wanted to show you a Universal. You can see an ominous-looking sky, especially off towards the south and the west, as some shower and thunderstorm activity is beginning to build up from the south and the west. Let me show you what it looks like on Storm Tracker radar. We have it in range now of Disney. If you take a look at the actual flow of things, the eastern side would brush a downtown Disney over towards Lake Buena Vista. ETA, by the way, right around 535 to 545-ish as it's moving off to the north-northeast now, gradually at about 15 to 20 miles an hour. Let's take a look at the bigger picture now throughout the entire viewing area. You can see we have one cluster here. That's the main show here locally. We had a complex of storms that was just west of Flagler County, but thankfully this one is moving off towards the north and the east, and it was actually a severe thunderstorm warning on that one, but it's pulling out of our area. That's the good news. The bad news is we're going to have to contend now with this cluster of storms. It's about to collide with an old cluster right over Citrus Ridge. The attractions, of course, right about in here. This is all on the outskirts of I-4 and lifting gradually back towards the north and the east. Now, if you're in downtown Orlando, what's intriguing about this is that the northern flank is weakening. So we're going to watch the southern end. It puts it over towards downtown Orlando now, roughly at about 40, 45 minutes from now, close to 6 p.m. this evening. So we'll watch the DOT cameras for you going forward. Lighter showers now over towards Leesburg. There's the West Coast sea breeze now trying to move on in, just west of and along I-75, beginning to flare up now. There's Ocala, there's Shady, there's 75, so we'll watch that carefully through the remainder of the evening hours. Lighter showers over towards Sanford, Deltona, back up towards Daytona, fairly quiet. There's that complex of storms going to miss Flagler County, thankfully, but we could use some rain up there. We think some of this energy will move back up that way later on this evening. The bigger picture shows things are quiet in Osceola and Brevard for now. Rainfall totals, Webster an inch and a half over towards Awaresdale, 1.25. Carver Middle School in Lake County, nearly an inch of rain. Where it's rained, the temperatures are in the lower 70s. Where it hasn't rained, we're still running 85 to about 87 degrees. You can see the onshore flow. That's going to drive the East Coast sea breeze in. That will keep things active now through about 8, 9 o'clock. Then thereafter, there may be a few lingering showers through the duration. And then overnight, tonight, things will slowly taper after midnight. Plenty of clouds overnight tonight with that front off to our north and our west. Overnight low temperature 67 Ocala, 70 in the Orlando area. Titusville, Melbourne, you'll be running right around 72 degrees. In the extended 7-day forecast, a very high chance for coverage of storms tomorrow, running at about 60% beginning mid-afternoon right through mid-evening. Wednesday, we're starting to dry things out gradually. Rain chances down to 50%, 40% on Thursday. Jim and Martha, as we head into the upcoming weekend now, you're going to see rain chances coming down to about 20% with those afternoon high temperatures running close to normal, right around 86 degrees.